from it.
We're good? Okay, we have 5 o'clock. We'll call the meeting to order. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Board of Adjustment. My name is Ken DeRoche. I'm chair of the board. Other members here this evening are Vanessa Mulhern and Ron Turner. To my right, we have Mr. Femi Ojo, who is representing the City of Winnipeg Property Planning and Development. And to my left is Inga Sudberg, who is acting secretary this evening. After hearing representation and support of and opposition to the applications, we will render our decisions. Please note that the board's decisions with respect to these applications may be appealed. Should you wish to appeal, information on how to do so will be included in the order, which will be mailed to all persons registered. The appeal will be held at City Hall at the date and time specified on the new notice that will be placed on the property. And can we have a motion to move the minutes of May 27th be taken as read and confirmed? Ron, thank you.
Yeah.
So all persons who wish to speak or receive notice of the board's decision must fill out a public representation slip. It looks like this, and submit it to me as soon as possible. Copies of this form are found at the registration table, which is at the top of the stairs. In accordance with the City of Winnipeg Charter and the Development Procedures Bylaw, the process the board will follow is the applicant will be heard first, followed by those in support of the application. Next, those registered in opposition are heard, followed by those registered for information. Finally, the applicant may return to speak in rebuttal to comments made. However, no new information is permitted. Please note that when your name is called, it is your opportunity to speak. However, you are not obligated to do so. This is the public hearing brochure. Copies of this were also at the registration table at the top of the stairs. It provides an overview of the process and other information pertaining to what happens before, during, and after a public hearing. This information, public hearings are recorded. And if you have any questions after the hearing is concluded, please contact the number listed in the brochure. The first public hearing before us tonight is an application for a variance at 0 North Town Road under file DAV115048 of 2015C.
Rory DeGray?
Yep.
All right, have a seat at the end of the table, please. And can we have your name and address for the record, please?
Rory DeGrave. Business address?
Yes.
52 Spears Road, SB.
Great.
Perfect.
Okay. And the city's recommending approval.
Okay.
Subject to one condition, or two conditions, really, but kind of the first one's kind of redundant, but to be expiring on June 10th of 2016. That's
yep.
good?
Yep.
Any questions of this board?
Nope.
Any questions to the applicant? Okay. Thank you, sir. Is there anybody else like to speak in support of the application for 0 North Town Road? Would you like to speak in opposition or require further information? No? Okay. Thank you, sir. Concerning the variance DAV115048, 2015C, 0 North Town Road, assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have to comply with, what is the will of the board? It'll be Vanessa.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That in accordance with subsection 247 sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I agree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to two conditions.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Thank you.
Second public hearing is an application for conditional use at 56 Gray Street under file DCU 116550 of 2015C.
And your name and address to the record, please.
My name is Ian Mighty, and I represent in Red River Valley Junior Academy, 56 Gray Street.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval with one condition that the conditional use expire June 30th, 2018. That's okay?
Well, we would like to request at least 5 years. I suppose that would take us to 2020.
2020?
Yes.
Okay. Any questions of this board?
No questions.
No.
Just
any questions of the applicant?
No. Okay. Make a presentation.
Okay. I wouldn't worry about that yet.
Okay.
Next, we have Colin. Are you here, Colin?
Yes.
Did you wish to speak, sir? We have you in support.
I could just speak briefly from here. Or
no, from there, please. Have a seat, please.
All right.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And your name and address for the record, please.
My name is Colin Aukry, and representing Red River Valley Junior Academy, which is 56 Gray Street as well. My address is 606 Hodnot Road.
Great.
And just wanted to speak in support of the motion that, as a board member of the school, we're excited about the growth of the school and the need for stability in terms of our long-range planning. We do request a 5-year permit extension.
Okay. Yeah, this item has been sitting on the land for some time already, right? It's in 2002, was it?
Well, there are two portables.
Two
there's
portables.
One that's been there since 2002. The most recent one is 2011 or 12.
Yeah.
2012.
Okay. What's the name of the school?
Red River Valley Junior Academy.
Okay. Thank you. And we also have Gilles Andre.
That's me.
We have you in support, sir. Did you wish to speak?
Just a few words. Yeah.
Okay. And if you give us your name and address also, please, sir.
Gilles Landry, and I'm representing Red River Valley Junior Academy at 56 Gray Street.
Okay.
And I just wanted to reiterate what these gentlemen were saying. I'm a member of the constituency of the school, and the school has a high enrollment. It has been in that neighborhood since about 1960 or so. It has been making a contribution to the city of Winnipeg for the last number of decades. And the temporary classroom is really an essential part of the school now because of the increase in enrollments. And there are some long-term plans to eventually, if possible, to expand the school, to buy another location, to build on it someplace else. But for the time being, that temporary classroom does serve a very important need for a lot of the children in Winnipeg.
Very good. Thank you, sir. Is there anybody else like to speak in support of the application for 56 Gray Street? Would like to speak in opposition? Or require further information? Thanks, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Concerning conditional use, DCU 116550 2015C 56 Gray Street, assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And that'll be Ron.
Mm-hmm. Move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
The receipt of public representation be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move that in accordance with Section 254 and Subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the conditional use is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. And it does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it's compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Polls carried.
Supporting comments, I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the conditional use be approved, subject to one condition.
Did you want to change that to 2020?
Yeah, 2020.
20? All in favor?
Yeah.
Opposed? Carried.
And I move the public hearing in respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I suppose I can take my presentation.
Okay, public hearing number 3 is an application for a variance at 106 Houchin Street under file DAB 121093 of 2015C.
And your name and address for the record, please.
Name, Manpreet Bueller, address 303 100 Princess Street.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval subject to two conditions. Did you have an opportunity to read those?
Yes.
Any issues or concerns?
No.
Okay. Any questions of this board?
No.
Any questions of the applicant?
No.
We also have the Darby Bueller. Did you wish to speak, sir? We have you in support.
No, I wouldn't.
You're good? Thank you very much. Is there anybody else who would like to speak in support of the application for 106 Couchon Street? Would like to speak in opposition? Require further information? No? Thank you.
Thank you.
Is there any variance DAV 121093 2015C 106 Couchon Street? Assuming all statutory requirements for this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll do Vanessa.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor, opposed, carry.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor, opposed, carry.
That in accordance with subsection 247 sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. It does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. It is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor, opposed, carried.
I agree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to two conditions.
All in favor, opposed, carried.
I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor, opposed, carried. Did you have something else? Okay. Did you have up there? The school board? You can leave. I don't know. I don't know why you guys. You can leave if you want. Okay.
Public hearing number 4 is an application for a variance at 2201 Logan Avenue under file DAV 126730 of 2015C.
And your name and address for the record, please.
Bruce King, 2500 360 Main Street.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval in part. I think they still want some landscaping out front.
That's fine.
That's okay?
Yep.
Okay, is there any questions for this board?
No questions, just one, I think, detail.
Okay.
On page 8 of the report.
Okay.
Under the reasons for recommendations, and I notice that when the resolutions are passed, people are reading these paragraphs.
Yes.
And not reading the reasons. In the reason under B and under C, I think there may be some language that's been carried over from another report, because there's a reference to a reduction in the east side yard for a display home, which has nothing to do with this application. So I think, again, as long as this committee is just making the motions that they describe here,
yes,
and ignoring six words under B and similar six words, because it, again, talks about temporarily to have a display home for sale, which again, I think accidentally may have been carried forward from another document. But otherwise, I think that the planner's report is just spectacular.
Okay. Yeah, they've been having trouble trying to get it from PP&D to city clerks. There's been constant conversation.
Don't worry,
that.
I deal with paper all day long and these things happen.
Okay, that's great. Thanks for noting that. Any questions to the board? No?
Nope.
Any questions to the applicant?
No.
Is there anybody else would like to speak in support of the application for 2201 Logan Avenue? Would like to speak in opposition or require further information? No? Okay, thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. You have another application here, don't you?
Hope not.
No? Well, okay. Okay, that's good. Concerning a variance DAV 126730 2015C 2201 Logan Avenue, assuming all statutory requirements in regard to this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll be Ron. Mm-hmm.
Move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed, carry.
Move the receipt of public representations to be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed, carry.
Move that in accordance with subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. And it does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor, opposed, carried.
Supporting comments, I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
Move the recommendation of the public service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to two conditions.
All in favor? Opposed, carried.
Move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed, carried. Thank you, sir.
Thanks.
And I'll go check and see if I have another one.
Public hearing number 5 is an application for a variance at 266 Bellevue Road under file DAV 126268 of 2015 C.
And your name and address, please.
It's Mohammed El Malaki, 235-530 Kennison Boulevard.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval subject to two conditions. Have you read those conditions?
Yes, sir.
Issues or concerns with those?
No.
Any questions of this board?
Not at the moment.
Any questions of the applicant?
No.
Is there anybody else who would like to speak in support of the application for 266 Bellevue? Speak in opposition or require further information? No. Thank you, sir. Concerning variance, DAV 126268 2015 C, 266 Bellevue Road. Assuming all statutory requirements in regards to this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll be with Vanessa.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry.
That in accordance with subsection 247 sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I agree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to two conditions.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Okay, public hearings 6 and 7, they're a combined hearing. Item number 6 is an application for conditional use at 375 Desmirons Street under file DCU 126828 of 2015 C. In accordance with the City of Winnipeg Charter and the Development Procedures Bylaw, as I indicated, it's a combined hearing, so the following item will also be heard at the same time. An application for a variance at the same premises under file DAV 126833 of 2015 C.
And your name and address, please?
It's Peter Dominic, 125 Crestwood Crescent.
Thank you. And for the conditional use, the city is recommending approval without conditions. And for the variance, the city is recommending approval with one condition, 2 years to establish. That's okay?
2 years to establish which, I'm sorry?
2 years to 2 years to get a permit.
Building permit for the...
Well, you have two suites in the basement.
Yep, yep,
I imagine.
Yep.
So you have to get a permit, right?
Right.
Yeah. Occupancy, sure. Or whatever.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's fine. Yeah, 2 years is fine.
Okay. Any questions of this board?
No, I'm fine.
No. Any questions of the applicant?
No.
Okay. Is there anybody else like to speak in support of the applications for 375 Desmirons? Like to speak in opposition, or require further information? No? Good. Thank you, sir.
Awesome. Thank you.
Is there a conditional use, DCU 126828, 2015C, 375 Desmiron Street, assuming all statutory requirements in regard to this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll be wrong.
Move the report of the public service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move that in accordance with Section 254 and Subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the conditional use is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. And it does not create a substantial adverse effect on amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it's compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Supporting comments, I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move the recommendation of Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in the conditional use be approved as applied for.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
And move public hearing respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Concerning the variance, DAV 126833 2015C 375 Desmirons Street, assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board?
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move that in accordance to subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, and it does not create a substantial adverse effect on amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it is the minimum modification of the zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry.
Supporting comments. I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
And move the recommendation to Olympic Public Service be concurred in, and the variance be approved subject to one condition.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry.
Move public hearing in respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry. Thanks, sir.
Thank you.
Number 8.
Public hearing number 8 is an application for a variance at 1700 Molson Street, 1054 and 1066 Springfield Road under file DAV 126783 of 2015 C.
Hi. Have a seat, please. And can you give us your name and address of the record, please?
Warner Laskich, 1700 Molson Street.
Thank you. And the city's recommending approvals. They have been 2 years to establish, but those buildings have been there for some time, right?
Yes.
So I think we're going to be recommending that as applied for. Okay, so any questions of the board? No?
I don't think so.
Okay, any questions of the applicant?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Is there anybody else who'd like to speak in support of the application for 1700 Molson and 1054 and 1066 Springfield Road? Would like to speak in opposition or require further information? Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Concerning variance, DAV 126783 2015 C, 1700 Molson Street and 1054 and 1066 Springfield Road. Assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll be Vanessa.
I move that the report of Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That in accordance with subsection 247 sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan.
All in favor? Oh, I'm sorry.
Does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. Is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated?
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I agree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in, and the variance be approved as applied for.
All in favor? And as amended?
As amended.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carry.
Public hearing number 9 is a variance at 60 Vivian Avenue under file DAV 125800-2015-C.
And your name and address, please.
Keith McLash, 293 North Hill Drive, Winnipeg, Manitoba.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval subject to five conditions. Have you read those conditions?
Yes, I have.
Any issues or concerns with those?
Nope.
Okay. We do have somebody here filed in opposition this evening. And so at this moment, we'll ask if you have any questions for the board.
Nope. Nothing.
Any questions for the applicant at this time?
None.
Okay. Is there anybody else like to speak in support of the application for 60 Vivian? Okay. Sir, if you'd like to have a seat, we're going to listen to the person's concerns, and you're going to have an opportunity to come back up and address those concerns. Okay? So we have Rita Ella Elias.
Okay, it's a down somewhere here?
Yeah, sure.
I'm the neighbor. Nasty neighbor in this case, probably.
Okay, and could we have your name and address for the record, please?
Rita Elias, 62 Vivian.
Very good. Go ahead, please.
Okay, we have been given very little information other than the posting that went up on the fence about a week ago that, okay, I knew it was going to be subdivided. I live next door. Next thing I know, there's stakes all over the place, which have got run over like mine did when I had it done. And they're taking a very narrow property with a narrow, very old tree on it and dividing it into two. And the neighborhood generally is bungalows. I don't have any information, that's the next one, as to what's going up there. It says a single family dwelling on one of the lots. What's the other lot being? A great big townhouse of some sort with people three-story townhouse. I don't get much sun as it is, and I'm not a mushroom.
Okay.
So I am not thrilled with what I am seeing. I'm seeing weeds next door. I'm seeing grass that's getting to be a foot high and no information. And I have some, I did do, where they come out with their lines and their stuff. And
survey?
We've surveyed. And we know there's some issues with the, this is another one where you know there's some issues with the way then the house, my house was built in 1922. Guess they weren't very accurate in those days. And should they move everything over, the fence is there now. We, the neighbor and I, put in a 6-foot fence between us. Good fences, good neighbors. And if they move it over to the line, I can't even get into the side by my where the garage is. So there's a few things that we need more information, I think, is where I'm really under than the opposition as to what's going to happen on that property.
Okay, tonight we're just discussing the split of the lot.
See, and nobody, again, lack of information, no idea.
Well,
what was on the, no things in our mailbox saying this is what's happening, just the thing on the fence.
Right, that the requirement is that the notification be posted on the property in visible sight, and it sounds like it as it has. On the posting, there are City of Winnipeg phone numbers, I believe, that you can phone the planning department and ask them specifically what's being done there. But other than that, I think that the rules have been followed correctly by the applicant in the posting. Again, like I say, we don't know what's going up there right now, but all we know that it is a single-family neighborhood, and if they were to deviate from the zoning that is on the property, again, a sign would have to go up. They would have to come here and ask for a variance or conditional use or whatever the situation is. And at that time, again, you have an opportunity to come back and let them know what you think about it.
Okay, fair enough. And it goes back to what's defined as a single-family dwelling, too.
Well, it could be a two-story home. It could be a bungalow. It could be a bi-level. I know the area, and I know there's a lot of two-story homes being with the infield in this area between St. Mary's and Desmurons and Desmurons to Egerton. All the way in the St. Mathilde area. It's a common thing that I'm sure you know the area.
Yeah.
You see what's going on there. So it's a lot of infill going on in the area. It's a desirable area.
Yeah, the infill sometimes three streets over leaves it to be desired, a lot to be desired.
Well, it's
atrocious monstrosity.
There's some interesting developments in there.
That's a politically correct way of saying it.
I think I know which one you're talking about.
I drive by it.
Well, I'm sure. We hope that the applicant has a sensitivity to the structures in the neighborhood.
Okay,
if he has that information available, he may not. He may just have at this moment just splitting the lot and going to get the plans later. Getting plans is not a cheap situation. So
fair enough. But then that's where I say other than posting, we have no information. And I thought, okay, I'm going to be brave. I'm coming down.
Yeah, great. But again, don't be like there are phone numbers on there for.
Okay, I didn't realize. If I missed them, I guess.
Yeah, there. Yeah.
When I saw that.
Yeah, it can be frightening if you don't know what's going on. Yeah, but just you can feel free to phone the PP&D anytime. Okay.
Okay. Fair enough. Thank you.
Thanks for your time. Is there anybody else like to speak in opposition to the application for 60 Vivian? Require further information? No? Okay, sir.
Okay, back to the variance. It's just a variance that we would require further information on?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll wait for the rest. So we'll be first.
Okay. Thank you. She doesn't really. Okay. That's. I think we're done then. Because there's nothing else to be said. Unless you did you have plans you wanted to speak about, or if that's not available yet?
We're putting up a bi-level house.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's cool. Okay, we're good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're going to continue. I think I asked for anybody else, didn't I?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thanks. Concerning variance DAV 125-800, 2015C, 60 Vivian Avenue, assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? And I'll be wrong.
I move that the report of Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor?
The public representation to be concluded.
All in favor? Post carry.
That in accordance with subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. It does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities used, safety and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and it's compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Both carried.
Supporting comments, I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to five conditions.
All in favor? Both carried.
I move the public hearing in respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Both carried. Thanks, sir.
Okay, public hearing number 10 is an application for a variance at 1400 St. James Street under file DAV 125738 of 2015 C.
And could you name an address, please?
Yeah. Jesse Brawley, 398 Daly Street North. Electra Signs, the company that we're
okay. The city's recommending rejection, but this is the kind of property signs that we have in the past. We have like a dozen or so that have come before us. And all you're doing is putting a reader board on an existing sign.
That's correct.
We understand the city has a policy that if any alteration is done, the sign comes down, you put a new 20-footer.
Correct.
So I think our members are going to be recommending approval of this.
Okay.
Okay.
I appreciate that.
Is there any questions?
If it's approval, then no. Then no. I can
I thought I could.
A big presentation for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, no, don't save it. Okay, any questions of the board at this time? Any questions of the applicant?
No.
Is there anybody else that like to speak in support of the application for 1400 St. James Street? Would like to speak in opposition or require further information? No. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Concerning a variance, DAV 125738 2015C, 1400 St. James Street, assuming all statutory requirements with regard to this application have been applied, but what is the will of the board? And that'll be Vanessa.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That the receipt of public representation be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That in accordance with subsection 247, sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities used, safety and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I agree with, or I disagree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service not be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to one condition that there's 2 years to establish.
All in favor? Did you have any other conditions with that?
No.
You're good? All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I move that the public representation with public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Thank you.
Okay, public hearing number 11 is an application for a variance at 6500 Roblin Boulevard under file DAV 116931 of 2015 C.
And your name and address, please?
Phoebe Balls with Outfront Media, 21 Bunting.
Thank you.
Can I distribute this?
Sure. Okay, so the city is recommending rejection of your application.
Correct.
And so the floor is yours.
Okay. So Outfront Media is requesting to vary the C4-dimensional standards of the zoning bylaw 200-206 for the erection of the billboard poster to permit as follows. Temporary change of the use for a period not to exceed 5 years to allow for the erection of the billboard use. And given the fact that I understand the billboard is visible from the adjacent residential use, but I will go into some details. 6500 Roblin is a neighborhood strip mall. It's nestled within the community of Charleswood, not a C4 commercial regional shopping, which is typically reserved for areas such as Polo Park, St. Patel, Garden City, Cologne Place, and Tuxedo Keniston Commons. Smaller neighborhoods, shopping centers are typically zoned C2 or C3, such as 4910 Roblin, 3520 Roblin, and 3605 Roblin, as well as 850 Kuwaitan. Billboards are permitted on these type of properties, which are zones C2 and C3. In regards to the proposed billboard being visible from nearby residential, I would like you to refer to the following handout. 3 Baker is approximately 282 feet away. 30 Willow Ridge is 183 feet away. 29 Willow Ridge is 240 feet away. 6428, I believe, which is right next door, which is on Sparrow, is located approximately 354 feet away. There is a side window which does have a view of the property and an existing pylon sign that is approximately about 178 feet away. That window actually looks into the subway. So it doesn't really have a direct view of the proposed billboard. However, we are proposing to plant coniferous-like trees on the property along Sparrow to block the view of the pylon and if any view of the proposed billboard. It is quite a ways away as it is. The billboard is not a major intrusion in the area, and it fits into the true character of the property. And it's more than 100 feet and more from the shielded residential areas. We're proposing to add a north shield on the light fixtures on both sides of the billboards to ensure there's no light deflecting into the north or northwest residential homes, which is on the last page of the handout. The subject variances is a minimal variation of the development bylaw. It's consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any secondary plan and does not create substantial adverse effects on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including areas separated from the property by the street or artery, compatible with the areas in which the property is situated. Thank you.
There's another pylon on this property. Does that make two sides?
It's an existing.
This one here, this on your.
Yeah, it's about a 30 feet, first party signage that has all the tenants that are.
That would be a freestanding sign.
Freestanding sign, but this is another sign.
Yeah,
that they're proposing.
It's a billboard poster.
Right. Now,
advertising.
Does that have an effect with the falling outside the 500 feet?
No. It has to be two billboards, not freestanding.
Okay, that answers that. Okay, any questions of this board at this time?
No.
Any questions of the applicant?
No.
No? Is there anybody else like to speak in support of the application for 6500 Roblin Boulevard? Would you speak in opposition or require further information? No? Thank you for your time, ma'am. Thank you. Concerning the variance, DAV 116931, 2015C, 6500 Roblin Boulevard, assuming all statutory requirements in regard to this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? Is that Ron?
Move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Move that in accordance with subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is not consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. And it does create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And it's not the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and it's not compatible with the area in which the property is effectively situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
Supporting comments agree with the planner's report.
Okay.
Move the recommendation the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and a variance be rejected.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
And move the public hearing in respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Thank you.
Public hearing number 12 is an application for a variance at 311 Belmont Avenue under file DAV 173129 of 2014C.
Hi.
Rick Rebel, 35 Victoria Crescent.
Thank you. And the city is recommending approval subject to three conditions. Have you read those conditions?
I have.
Any issues or concerns?
Not at all.
Any questions of this board?
No.
Any questions of the applicant?
No.
No? Okay, we also have Paul Peters here. Sir, we have you in support. Did you wish to speak?
Yes.
You're good. And we also have John Bertie. Bertley?
Yes.
We have you in support. Did
yes.
you wish to speak, sir?
No, I'm okay.
You're good? Okay. Is there anybody else who would like to speak in support of the application for 311 Belmont Avenue? Would like to speak in opposition? Require further information? No? Thank you, sir. Thank you. Concerning the variance, DAV 173129 2015C, 311 Belmont Avenue, assuming all statutory requirements for this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? That would be Vanessa.
I move that the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
That the receipt of public representations be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
that in accordance with subsection 247, sub 3 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan, does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway, is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effect of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I agree with the comments contained in the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move that the recommendation of the Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved subject to three conditions.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried.
I move that the public hearing with respect to this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed? Carried. Good. Thank you, gentlemen. Okay. Here we go.
So, yeah, our final application before us tonight, public hearing number 13, is an application for a variance at 505 Denisset Street under file DAB 124787 of 2015 C.
Hi. I thought I screwed up here, but it's you again.
Greg Grewall, 35 Victoria Crescent.
Thank you very much. Okay. The city is recommending approval subject to four conditions. Have you read those conditions?
Yes, I have.
Any issues or concerns with
those?
Not
at all.
No, okay. Just to let you know, we do have a few people here in opposition. But just to give an idea, you're going to demo the building?
No. It was an existing lot purchased from the city of Winnipeg.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so you're...
We're varying the lot area in order to put a house.
Okay,
there.
Right. You're going to make it two-family dwelling.
Right. It's R2 zoning already.
It's already R2. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. So the variance is because the lot is required for 3,500 square feet.
That's right.
And it's a smaller lot.
Right.
Okay. So we also have John again here.
Yeah, he's...
He's gone?
He's
okay.
In support of...
Okay. So is there anybody else like to speak in support of 505 Denisset? No? Okay, sir. So again, I'm going to have a seat, and we'll listen to those in opposition, and if there's anything you can answer, we'll bring you back up. Okay? So we'll go to those in opposition now. And we'll start off with Patricia McPhillips. In opposition? Thank you. Ida Musso? We have you in opposition?
Yes.
Did you wish to speak? And if you can give us your name and your address for the record, please.
Ida Musso, 503 Denison.
Thank you.
As a neighbor, I'm really opposed to that because I don't know what kind of a house is being built. Is it going to be a one-story single-family dwelling?
No, it's going to be, they're requesting a two-family, to build a two-family home. The zoning permits it, okay? Your R2 zoning permits two-family homes on Denisset. And, you know, in that region from the St. Archibald, Marion, you know, to Denisset, it's R2. The reason why he's here is because the size of the lot. That lot is 1,650 square feet. And when you build a two-story home, the zoning in R2 says you should have 2,500 square feet. So that's why he's here. He needs a variance. He wants to vary the zoning so that he's allowed to build that size of home on this size of a lot. So it is a two-family, and I don't know. Is it a two? It would have been a two-story probably. Was it a duplex? Is this a duplex one?
Yes, a duplex.
It was a duplex. Yeah. So it's an up and down situation.
Well, that's a very tall building right next to.
Well, the zoning only permits 35-foot height. So if he intends to build higher than 35 feet, again, he would have to come back here and make a request to have that as a to vary that height restriction. But it's a two-story home.
Okay, and two families on a 26-foot wide lot, isn't that a little crowded? The parking, it's a dead-end street. We only have limited parking. We don't have an access right through.
Well, I imagine you have enough parking in the back on a 26-foot lot, I would assume.
For two?
Sure.
With the trees and...
You would be required only two parking stalls, and that would fit.
Yeah. Again, he's required to have two parking stalls under this zoning again. Okay. And there is, the planner suggests that there is room for two cars.
Okay.
Anything else?
Anybody else?
Anything from you?
I don't know what else to say.
Okay. Okay. Thank you very much for your attendance. That was Ida. Next we have Melody Morissette. Melody, we have you in opposition. Did you wish to speak? Great. And your name and address, please.
Melody Morissette, 541 Denisette Street.
Thank you. Go ahead.
I'd just like to register my opposition to the increase in square footage due to the character of the neighborhood. The majority of them are very small homes, which allows for plenty of yards and gardens and light. And we've sort of developed a community where everybody knows each other. A lot of them are long-term residents who intend to stay in those properties and not actually sell and develop larger things. Although I know that there are plenty coming in the neighborhood, I'd like to say that our street is a particularly quiet and small street that's just on the river without a other side to the street.
Right.
And so I don't think it would fit in this particular part of the neighborhood.
Okay. Thank you for your attendance.
Thank you.
And then we have Sarah McGinsey. Hi, McGinsey. We have you in opposition. Did you wish to speak?
Sure.
And your name and address for the record, please.
My name is Sarah McGimsey, and I live at 509 Denison.
Thank you.
I'm in opposition to this because I agree with Melody, who said that the majority of the homes in this area are very small. Most of the people who have been living in this area have been there, their families have been there for 50 to 60 years. The majority of the people there, it's a beautiful spot where people are not planning on moving. They're not planning on selling their homes. They want to stay there, and they want to keep it small. We're in an area right now where people are talking about having an overpass coming in, and we're having meetings with 150 people showing up because they do not want development coming into the area. This is an area where there has been, I think, one duplex that was built last year on Tremblay that is very big, which I guess would have been the 35 feet, and it towers above everything else. A lot of people were very upset about this. So those are some things I wanted to voice as a concern in this area. Something else I'd also like to say in regards to the application for this, I know that there was a neighbor that was written in as having supported this. That person was Ida, who signed something or was asked to sign something, but obviously did not understand what she was signing or obviously did not, you know what she was signing. So I think that that should also be taken into consideration with the application for this. The other part of this application was that there, it stated that there was a duplex at, I think, 529 Denisée. And that was another thing saying that, look, this has already been developed in the area. Sorry, I'll give you a moment.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, so that would have to be taken from that, I would think, because... this is, you know, a woman who did not understand what she was signing. I wasn't there, so I'm not sure what exactly happened at that time.
Yeah.
The other thing I would like to say is that a part of the application stated that there is a duplex at 529 Denisée. If you have Google Maps, you can see the building. Now, this home, would be called a duplex in the sense that there's an upstairs and there's also a downstairs. There is a mother who's there who rents the bottom part to her son, and it is a complete set or a suite, sorry. But it is the size of all the other homes in the area. It is not larger. It is not a larger foot. So I just wanted to say, you know, perhaps that when the urban planner was looking at that and thinking that this was an area that has these sorts of things there, that it really is not. There's only one building that has been built larger than everything else, and that is what has been built on Tremblay, and many people were really upset. So thank you for your time.
And then Francois, is it Francois? We have you in opposition, sir. Did you wish to speak?
Yes.
Come on up. Oh, sure. And your name and address, please?
My name is François Le Goupil. I live at 501 Denizé. I'm the partner of Sarah.
Thank you.
So first of all, I'd like to underline three things that I think in the process have not been very regular. First of all, reading the bylaws, we knew that a sign had to be posted. Mm-hmm. This sign was not posted. I had to inquire, read the bylaws. 2 hours later, I called the city clerk, and 2 hours later, the gentleman posted the sign. Second of all, as Sarah said, it seems that he approached our neighbor across the lot and made her sign something she obviously didn't understand, on the second breaching to me of the process. Furthermore, it seems to me that if there is this meeting, this public meeting, for a variance, which means nothing has been decided yet, we are correct, aren't we? Mm-hmm. It happens that before the posting, before the signing was put in front of the lot, there were material construction in front of the lot, which means the third breach of the process. That was the first three things. And moreover, we don't have anything to say against the fact that the lot has been sold. This was. The problem is that if you look at all the streets, not only our streets, all the streets, single houses, assets are our small houses. Why are you going to put a duplex or a triplex in a street when you just have single houses, even if it's R2? This is single houses. Give me a minute here, please. Mm-hmm. Yeah, first of all, there is the problem of the access. We live in a dead hand. Denizé Street is not a complete street. During the 1950s, when the flood, the road got cut, which means it's a cul-de-sac, right? Mm-hmm. So if you had more cars, it just ain't going to make things even worse. And moreover, during the winter, this part in front of the house is not even plowed by the city. One thing. Second thing about the lot. Yes, put yourself in my shoes. We are house owners, me and my neighbor. We want to sell the house down the road. All the houses on the street are single houses. Somebody comes, look at everything, say, oh my God, these two houses are beside this building, this duplex. There's no light. How do you think that the resale value of the house is going to go? Just put yourself in our shoes. People who come in the neighborhood, they're going to see, oh, it's just single houses. It's very nice. And you got this in the middle of the street. How is that going to affect the resale value of our houses?
No, we don't really know that, do we?
We know the answer.
Not really.
If somebody has to choose between a houses who is surrounded by single houses and a houses who's got beside it,
well,
the
that's
duplex.
All speculation, sir. I mean, you don't have any documented evidence to support that claim. So, I mean, you can say anything you'd like, but I mean, really, that really hasn't been shown in fact to this board at any particular time with all infill housing. We had one earlier this evening too, but we've never had anything come before us that. Infill housing, no matter if it's a single family or two family. A two-story home is a two-story home, whether it's one or two families. Doesn't detract from the value of the
neighborhood. If somebody wants to move into a neighborhood, they move into the neighborhood. But we certainly haven't seen any documented proof that these things affect the value of adjoining properties.
Would you rather buy a house who's got light or a house who's got complete shade all the time? As simple as that. To me, it's just there's no need to make a survey.
Okay, anything else? That's good. Thank you for your time, sir. Oops, I'm sorry. I think we... Patricia McPhillips, did we talk to you already?
Yeah, it's okay.
Thank you. Okay. And your name and address, please.
Patricia McPhillips, 513 Danisette Street.
Very good.
I'm mostly concerned, like everyone else said, about the fact that a duplex, a two-story duplex, is out of character with everything else in the neighborhood. But I'm more concerned about the fact that the infrastructure on the street does not support that kind of population density at that end of the street. It's a gravel road. It's rarely plowed in the winter time. In the spring, when it thaws, you have to come down the lane and come around to the front of the Danisette Street. It's mud there. The infrastructure, the road, won't support that kind of population density in that area, and that's a concern for me. Plus, as everyone else said, the size of the home is out of proportion with everything else in the neighborhood, particularly that little half block.
Okay. Thank you very much. Is there anybody else like to speak in opposition to the application at 505 Danisette or require further information? No? No, you've already been up. You can't. Okay, so we'll get Mr. Grewal up. I'm not sure what else he can say. Hi. I'm not sure if there's any questions that were put forward to you that you could answer, if there anything.
I'd just like to add that the lot is currently zoned for a two-family dwelling. It's purchased from the city of Winnipeg. All we're doing is amending the lot area for the home. And I spoke with the planner. She had made some recommendations to keep it in character with the street itself, and I accommodated those suggestions to make it to fit in as best as we can.
Okay. Thank you for your time. Okay. I think these are all yours, I think. That's Patricia? Right. Okay, we're good. Thank you. Okay, we're good. Okay, concerning variance DAV 12478720015C, 505 Danisette Street, assuming all statutory requirements regarding this application have been complied with, what is the will of the board? I'll be wrong.
I move the report of the Winnipeg Public Service be taken as read.
All in favor, opposed, carried.
Proceed. Public representations to be concluded.
All in favor, opposed, carried.
That in accordance with subsection 2473 of the City of Winnipeg Charter, the variance is consistent with Plan Winnipeg and any applicable secondary plan. It does not create a substantial adverse effect on the amenities, use, safety, and convenience of the adjoining property and adjacent area, including an area separated from the property by a street or waterway. And is the minimum modification of a zoning bylaw required to relieve the injurious effects of the zoning bylaw on the applicant's property, and is compatible with the area in which the property to be affected is situated?
All in favor? Opposed, carried.
Supporting comments, I agree with the planner's report.
Thank you.
I move the recommendation to Winnipeg Public Service be concurred in and the variance be approved, subject to four conditions.
All in favor? Opposed, carried.
And move the public hearing respect this application be concluded.
All in favor? Opposed, carried. So the board has agreed with the city's recommendation to allow the variance, but as I mentioned earlier, our decisions can be appealed. And how to do that is going to be included with the order that Inga will send to everybody who has been registered. Okay? And I thank you all for attending this evening. Thank you. And Ms. Nessa, can I have a motion to adjourn? Thank you. Thank you, Femi. Mm-hmm.